So let's start today's class.
Today, we will learn how the gravity value changes with height. As we are going above and above from the Earth's surface, acceleration due to gravity will decrease or increase. Tell me. Yes. It decreases, है ना? As we are going above the Earth surface, above
yes,
and above,
sir.
The acceleration due to gravity value decreases. That's what we are going to learn in today's class. So let's start. Now, consider this is a Earth. Yes, and I am taking one small object whose mass is small m, and this is Earth whose mass is capital M. Okay, now see here. This is what radius of Earth. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And now, where is object? Object is above the Earth's surface. Which is at height, let us suppose h. This height is h, and the radius of Earth is r. Yes.
మొత్తం ఆ బ్రేక్ టైం కూడా చూస్తాం.
ఓకే, సో దిస్ ఇస్ రేడియస్ అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ హైట్ హెచ్ అట్ విచ్ వన్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఇస్ దేర్. ఓకే, నౌ వాట్ వీ హావ్ టు డూ, వీ హావ్ టు ఫైండ్ గ్రావిటీ అట్ దిస్ పాయింట్. లెట్ అస్ అజూమ్ దాట్ దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ the point A, we can say, which is on the Earth's surface. And this is point B, which is at height h from the Earth's surface. Okay. Now, at Earth's surface and at point B, which is at height h, how the gravity changes, that we are going to calculate. So first of all, see here, at point B, gravitational force exerted by Earth on this mass is equal to what? Gmm divided by r plus h whole square. Okay? Yes, no? This is what gravitational force. Call this equation number one. Now, weight of body, you know, weight is equal to W, which is equal to mgh. What is gh here? Acceleration due to gravity at height h. Now,
What should be the case? Gravitational force is equal to weight. Enough. Gravitational force is equal to weight. Gravitational force is equal to weight. And therefore, can I write like this? MGH is equal to, either you can write this or like this also you can write, not an issue, okay? Like this. GMM divided by R plus H whole square is equal to MGH. Now, this M and this M will get cancelled. And what we are getting, GH, GM divided by R plus H whole square. Understood? Yes. What is the gravity at this height? GH is equal to GM by R plus H whole square. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Call this equation number 3. Okay, right. Let's go ahead. Now, at
sir, wait for 2 minutes. Sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, 2 minutes.
What he
is asking? Asking you not to erase, sir.
No, no, no. I'm not erasing. Wait.
Okay,
not
sir.
Erasing. Every page will be there. Don't worry. Listen. So now, first listen. I will give time. At point B, okay? At point B. At point A. B, this is finished already. Hai na? At point A. At point A means where, Ray? On the surface or on the at height? Yes?
Sir.
Surface, hai na? On the surface, you can see in the diagram. What is the gravity? G is equal to GM by R square. Call this equation number 4. Hai na? Gravity at this surface is what? GM by R square. Yes, no? Here also, how you got? You know this. So, now, from equation 3 and 4, from equation 3 and 4, let's divide these two. What happens? See, GH divided by G is equal to GM divided by R plus H whole square divided by GM by R square. So what I can cancel now? This GM will get cancelled with this GM. This R square will come up. So what is our formula? GH by G is equal to R square divided by R plus H whole square. Yes, no? What we got formula C? GH by G is equal to R square by R plus H whole square. Yes, sir. Understood. Okay. Right. So,
can you explain from that substitution, sir, from equation 3 and 4?
Equation?
From equation 3 and 4, you substituted, sir, that you explained.
Just you divide, Ray. Equation 3 is there now. This one, GH divided by G. GH value is what? GM by R plus H whole square. G value is what? GM by R square. Now, this GM cancel. This is 1 by r plus h whole square. This is 1 by r square. So this r square will go up. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
See here. I am writing here so that you will understand. Now gh by g is equal to. Here what left ray?
1 by
r plus h whole square. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right? And yes, sir. Divided by, this is what left ray now, 1 by r square left.
R square.
So now this is what I am doing here. Can I write like this? 1 by r plus h whole square into, this is reciprocal na, r square by 1. Hai ki nahi? We know na,
yes, sir.
A by b divided by c by d. I can write a by b into d by c. Agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, na.
Yes, sir.
And that's why I got gh by g is equal to r square by r plus h whole square. Is that clear now? Understood?
Yes, sir. Thank
you. Understood, sir.
Okay. Right? So, this part you can write somewhere at corner. Okay. Whatever I have written this. This is just for your understanding purpose. Okay. If you want, you can write somewhere. Clear? Okay.
Okay, and
now, see here. Can I write after this step? That is, therefore, GH is equal to, this G I am transferring here. So, G into r square divided by r plus h whole square. So can I keep it in box? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt, please ask. Check it once. Everything is right. Check it once. Any doubt? Yes, no. Understood.
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. And keep it in mind one point, that is acceleration due to gravity decreases with increase in height. Okay. As height increases, acceleration due to gravity decreases. Agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Shall I go to the next page with your permission?
1 minute, sir.
1 minute, sir.
Okay. Switch off your video, please.
Done, sir.
Yes, everyone finished.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Understood.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shall I go to the next page?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. One small problem. Find the acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity at a height equal to 2R, where R is radius of Earth, that is 6400 kilometer, and given, that is small g at the surface, is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Shall I solve?
Yes, sir.
Right, listen. Now, what is given here? Here, h is given, h is equal to 2r. And R is equal to 6400 kilometer. Okay. Also, they have given G on the surface. So, this is 9.8 meter per second square. And G at height is equal to how much they are asking. Okay. This is Earth. And assume that one of the object is here, which is at height. How much height is equal to 2 times of radius of Earth? And this is given, that is how much? Radius of Earth. Okay. Clear? Now, what is our formula? Let's use it. What is our formula? GH is equal to G into R square divided by R plus H whole square. Substitute the values. This is G and this is R square divided by R plus 2R whole square. This is equal to G into R square divided by 3R whole square. And therefore, GH is equal to G into R square divided by 9R square. Now I am canceling this R square with this R square. And what I am getting now? GH is equal to 1 by 9. Into G at surface. And therefore, what is the gravity at that height? 1 by 9 into 9.8. Yes, no? So, what is the value of this? 9.8 by 9. Can anyone tell me? Yes. 1.0 8.88 meter per second square. Is that clear? Any doubt? Check it once. Everything is right. Check it once. Yes. Please check it. Everything is right.
Sir.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So answer will be
yes, sir.
1.088 meter per second.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Yes, Rishabh. Shall I go to the next page?
1 minute, sir.
1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Sir, GS means gravitation of surface. Sir.
Gravity at surface. Acceleration due to gravity at surface. Okay. That is G only. If you will write only G also enough, okay? Because here already G I have mentioned now. G means definitely that is at surface only. Okay?
Yes.
This is 9 and G, little different you write, okay? Like this. This is 3, this is 9.
Finish, sir.
Done, sir.
Okay. Shall I go to the next page?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see. Note point. Note point. If H is very, 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 very less than R, this is what? H is very, 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 very less than R. H is very, very small. Compared to R. What is that? If H is very, very less than R means H is very, very small or less than R. Okay. Then how we have to calculate or which formula we have to use. Okay. So see here what I am using. Now we have formula that is GH is equal to G into R square divided by R plus H whole square. Now what I am doing, see here, I am taking this G and I am keeping all this under one bracket, we can say. Can I keep like this? Is it okay? Can I keep like this? Yes or no? Yes, no. Yes? Square, square only. Can you hear me? Yes or no?
Please tell.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now what I am doing, you see, this is equal to G into R plus H divided by R whole power minus 2. Hai na? Minus 2.
Yes, sir.
Can I write like this? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Minus 2. Now, see here what I am doing. I am just separating denominator now here. So R by R plus H by R whole power minus 2. And this is equal to G into 1 plus H by R whole power minus 2. Understand? Till here, understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now see.
Yes, sir.
As H is very, 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 very less than R, and so definitely this H by R is also, therefore, H by R is less than 1. Yes or no? Because this is definitely less, means definitely its value is very, very less than 1. Anna?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, 1 plus H by R whole power minus 2 is equal to 1 minus 2 H by R. How you got this? I am writing here. Okay. Why I am keeping this power here? With proof, I will show you. Listen here. In mathematics, we are having binomial theorem. Binomial theorem. And what this theorem is saying, if 1 plus x whole power n you want its expansion, and if is equal to 1 plus n into x, if x is very, 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 very less than 1. If like this bracket is there, then what you have to do? You have to keep this power here and just multiply. We are getting higher terms also, but that is not necessary for us. So 1 plus x whole power n is equal to 1 plus nx if x is equal very, very less than 1. Here also you see 1 plus, this is x, assume karo, means h by r is x, and now x is very, very less than 1. That's why this minus 2 power is coming here, and that's why your expansion becomes 1 minus 2 h by r. Understood? Yes. Let's take one example for your understanding. Suppose now I am having like this, 1 plus 0.01 whole square. And now I want to expand this. So see here, also 0.01 is very, very less than 1. Yes or no? Therefore, what I should do? 1 plus 2 into 0.01, which is equal to 1.02. Understand? Sir, you prove this by doing...
Yes, sir.
Yes, I am proving. See here. Suppose now 1 plus 0.01, I am doing directly square. So what I am getting? 1.01 whole square I am getting. Now you see, if you will do this with calculator, you should get nearly equal to 1.02. So see, I am doing that also. 1.01 whole square, if you will do, you will get 1.0201. Understand? Is that clear? Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That's why I can write 1 minus 2h by r. So therefore, I am getting gh is equal to g into 1 minus 2h divided by r. This is what the formula when h is very, 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 very less than r. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please note down. Any other doubt, please ask.
Okay, sir.
This also you just write down at corner only, there only in the notebook, so that whenever you will refer next time, you should understand. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So once can you show first page, sir?
First or second or?
First, sir.
Take this.
Sir, one's last bit, sir.
Yes, finished everyone. Please tell.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
1 minute, sir.
Done, sir.
Okay. So let me give you small homework problem on this model. Number one, given H is equal to 3R and G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Calculate GH. Which formula will you use? Which formula will you use? GH by G is equal to R by R plus H whole square.
Whole okay? Square.
Yaad rakho. Question number two. Given H is equal to 200 meter and R is equal to 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter. Calculate GH. Okay, which formula you will use? Which formula you will use? Which formula you will use? GH is equal to G into 1 minus 2H by R. Okay. Will you do this now? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do it slowly. Don't commit any mistake. This is 6,400 kilometer. So I have converted it into meter. Okay. 6,400 into 10 to the power 3. That is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6. So slowly do it. Okay. Don't commit any mistake. Right? Need clean solution set.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Right.
Okay, sir.
So let's stop here for today. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Enjoy the day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.